Now in class 12th, I am taking the topic total internal reflection. This kind of phenomena takes place when the light ray travels from denser medium to rarer medium. Internal reflection. The light ray travels from denser medium to rear view. Rear view. So this is the interface. Interface XY. And this we suppose that this is the normal our denser medium. So this is now water and here it is air. This is our normal. This is now incident ray and this is now refracted ray, R. This is now angle of incidence, I. This is now angle of refraction, R. As I told you earlier also that when the light ray is refracted from denser medium to rare medium, the angle of refraction is always more than the angle of incidence. So angle of incidence that is equal to I and angle of refraction that is equal to R. Now clearly this angle of refraction R is greater than I. So now as the angle of incidence is increased, as the angle of incidence is increased, the angle of refraction will increase. So now that we are having this angle of incidence is like this one. This has increased. When angle of incidence is like this, then the light ray grazes along the interface. So at this, the angle of refraction is equal to 90 degrees. Becomes 90 degree or right angle. Right angle. It means the refracted ray grazes along the interface. Along the interface. So this is grazing like this one. Then this angle is equal to 90 degrees. This angle becomes 90 degrees. This is now 90 degrees. Here the angle is 90 degrees. Then this angle, for which the angle of refraction is equal to 90 degree, is called the critical angle. This particular angle of incidence . This is now angle of incidence IC, denoted by IC. And if this is further increased like this, then light ray will be reflected in the denser medium. So this angle becomes, this angle is greater than, this is not so much, this angle, this is now IE greater than IC. Hear this, IE greater than IC. This is more than reflected. This is reflected. So when angle of incidence is more than the critical angle, then light ray is not reflected, but this is reflected in the same medium. This kind of lumina is called the total internal reflection. So this angle of incidence, for which this angle of refraction becomes 90 degree, that is called the critical angle. So this is what I am writing here, that this particular angle of incidence, for which angle of refraction is 90 degree is called critical angle. Critical angle denoted by IC. So this critical angle is different for the different mediums, and as you can see that if IE is greater than IC, the light ray the light ray is reflected in the same medium. Reflected in the same medium. It is called total internal reflection. Total internal reflection. And when this the eye is greater than I see, then no reflection takes place. The light ray is simply reflected in the same medium. So this total internal reflection takes place when this I is greater than IC. So now you can see if we apply the Snell's law. Applying the Snell's law. Now this light ray is going from water to air. Denser to rare. So we have this W mu A sin I upon sin R is equal to W mu A, because light ray is going from water to air. When I equal to IC, R equal to 90 degree. Therefore, this sin IC upon sin 90, this is equal to W mu A. Or we can have this sin 90 is equal to 1, so sin IC is equal to W mu A. So this is the refractive index of air with respect to water. So we can have or A mu W is equal to 1 upon sin IC. A mu W is the refractive index of water with respect to air. This is now equal to so much. So or generally this can be written as or mu equal to 1 upon sin IC. So the refractive index is the reciprocal of sin of the critical angle IC, or this can also be written like this one, sin IC equal to 1 upon mu, or IC equal to sin inverse 1 upon mu. This is not so much. It is the relationship between the refractive index of the medium and the angle, critical angle IC. So we can have that the critical angle is equal to the sine inverse of 1 upon mu. Therefore, or we can also can see that the mu into sine IC is equal to 1. One more relation that we can have this mu into sin IC, this is equal to 1. This is not so much. The product of the refractive index and the sin of the critical angle is equal to 1. Thus, refractive index is equal to the reciprocal of sine of critical angle. Critical angle. So this is what the relationship between the refractive index and the sine IC. So we can have this nu equal to sine IC, that is equal to 1, or we can write it like this one, we can write it like this one also. So these are the forms. The actual is this one, and from this we can derive this relation, we can derive this one. So this is now like this. So this phenomena is called the total internal reflection. So there are two conditions for total internal reflection. Conditions. Number one, the light ray must travel from denser medium to rarer medium. It means that the reflection must take place from denser to rarer. Second condition is that the angle of incidence must be greater than critical angle. Critical angle. Critical angle of incidence must be greater than the critical angle. So if these two conditions are satisfied, only then the total internal reflection will take place. Otherwise, there is no total internal reflection. Dependence of critical angle now critical angle depends upon the medium. So for the different mediums it will have the different values. The angle IC, critical angle IC, is different for different mediums. Different mediums. So it depends from medium to medium. Since this is dependence upon the refractive index, and we know that refractive index depends upon the wavelength, so critical angle will also depend upon the wavelength of the light used and the temperature of the medium. If the temperature of the medium is increased, then angle of incidence will change. because by increasing the temperature, the medium becomes lighter or it becomes rare. Because of that, the refractive index changes. So this IC will change. It also depends upon the wavelength of light used and the temperature. Temperature of the medium. This I will tell you that the refractive index depends upon the two factors. One is the wavelength, second the temperature. For different, the single medium may have the different angle, different value of I, sorry, different value of mu. So because of that, this IC will change. So depending upon the temperature and the wavelength, this angle of critical angle different for the same medium. So because of that, we are having that this critical angle depends upon the different mediums. If suppose all the mediums are at the same temperature, then this will be different for different medium. If we use the different wavelength for the single medium, then the value of mu will be different. And if we change the temperature of the medium, then this mu will be different. So depending upon the value of mu, the critical angle depends upon them. So this is what, that the critical angle is different for the different materials, different wavelengths and the temperature of the medium. There are so many phenomena depending upon the total internal reflection. So that I will discuss you later, but here I am telling you the examples of this one. Examples of total internal reflection. Now one depth is first fiber. Now in this total internal reflection, there is one more benefit, that 100% energy is reflected, nothing is absorbed or transmitted. So there is no loss of energy in total internal reflection. So these optical fibers are based on the phenomena of total internal reflection. Now the mileage this is also depending upon the total internal reflection. This is the illusion, optical illusion, that I will discuss later. So there's so many, there are the prisms like the right angle prism that also reflects the light, and number three that we have the shining of the diamonds. The brightness of diamond. Diamond has the most But this, because of total internal reflection, so the diamond is so constructed that when the light ray falls on the surface, the angle of incidence is always more than the critical angle. So this is always total internally reflected. So because of that, it appears to be a very shiny one. Prisms. Prisms like this, suppose we are having this prism. This is now light ray falling on it, and this is now reflected like this. So this is the incident, this is now reflected, so this is the angle of incidence here. This angle of incidence, this is I greater than IC. Similarly, we have the triangles like this. So this also the sum. When the test tube filled with water is kept inside the water, then it shines because of the total internal reflection. So these are some of the phenomena that are based on the total internal reflection. So you all like, share and subscribe the video. Thank you very much.